that stop the profits?
Someone that I spoke to from there that
thank you.
I believe that was a really small part. How do I know that it's true? How do I know that it might not be the devil? How do I know? Sat there, like I was praying there, and I could be at home.
I might sit down. Sometimes I'll be private, but I didn't get close to me. I mean, and I kneel down. But in my heart,
be some that trouble you and pervert the gospel of Christ. But though we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached, let him be accursed. So Paul is saying that there is a true gospel. That there is a true gospel, and he says, but though we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. And there are lots of manipulation going on, lots of cults today. that tried to manipulate us, tried to get us into their cult. They say they've seen an angel, or they say they're the way. And Paul warns about it. He says, but for we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached, let it be accursed. And we have to be careful with who we hang around with and where we go. Because there's a lot of deception going on. There's a lot of cults going out there trying to chop our minds. Or an angel from heaven preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. In other words, if you preach falsely, a false Christ, there is only God's judgment on that. There is only one true gospel. And that gospel is this, that he says, who gave himself for our sins. You're right. You're hungry. Gave himself for our sins that he might deliver us from this present evil world according to the will of God and Father. He says, who gave himself for our sins? Who gave himself for our sins? That is the gospel. Who gave himself for our sins? He gave himself for our sins. Jesus Christ gave himself for our sins. He died in our place. It says, for God demonstrates his own love to us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And Christ died in your place. He died in my place, that you may live and that I may live. God demonstrates his own love to us, that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. And when he died on that cross, he died on your behalf. He died on my behalf. And he took your punishment for the things that you did wrong. The things that I did wrong. He died in your place. He died in my place. And shed his blood.
Come out. Alright.
Are you not going on?
Yeah, I'll be. I'm just looking at you, Ted.
Though we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you, than that which we have preached unto you, let it be a curse. Let it be a curse. Why? Because of this. Who gave himself for our sins that he might deliver us from this present evil world according to the will of God our Father. Who gave himself for our sins. Christ stepped in your place and he stepped in my place and he shed his blood and died on that cross on your behalf. That's why he died on that cross. He died on that cross on your behalf for you. That's why he died on that cross.
We're going to pray
Jesus. He died on that cross for you, sir.
Give him, I need
he
you
did.
To
he died on that cross
go
for you, sir.
To hell with
he
it.
Died on the cross.
Get lost.
Don't you believe that, sir?
Get lost.
Why don't you believe it?
Get lost.
Who gave himself for our sins.
And he might.
He died for you, sir. He died for you, sir, on that cross. Who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from this present evil world according to the will of God. It was God's will. It was God's will that Jesus Christ die on your behalf. It was God's will that Jesus Christ shed his blood for your sin. It was God's will that he died in your place. It was God's will that he took the punishment upon his son for you. It was God's will, my friend, who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from this present evil world according to the will of God our Father, who gave himself for our sins. Jesus Christ gave himself for our sin. And that means if you are a sinner today, if you've done wrong, if you've broken the Ten Commandments, don't lie, don't steal, don't commit adultery, honor your father and mother, honor the Sabbath day. If you have broken those Ten Commandments, and broke those commandments, it says this. It says, who gave himself for our sins, that he might deliver us from the present evil world. We live in an evil world, a world that's in a mess, a world that's falling apart. But it begins in your own heart, in my heart, in your heart. It begins there to know that my heart is sinful, your heart is sinful. We are all sinful, we are all failed. Who gave himself for our sins that he might deliver us from this present evil world. But he says, grace be to you and peace from God. There's only real grace, only real peace in Jesus Christ and him dying for you on that cross. And knowing that he died on that cross, that is the only peace for you. That is the only real peace. Know that you're resting in the peace of God in the blood of Jesus Christ. That is the only peace that you can have in this world. The only real peace is to know that you're right with the living God. To know that you're right with God and clean with God because of the blood of Jesus. That is the only peace that you can have in this world. It is the only peace worth having. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. It's not only from God the Father, but it's from Jesus Christ. That Christ is the same as the Father. They are co-equal, for they are God. There is only one God, but Jesus Christ is equal with the Father. He is God, and he came and died on that cross that you may be reconciled to him. That he might deliver us from this present evil world according to the will of God our Father, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. He says, to whom be glory. He says, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. Why does he do that? Why does he do that? Why does he say, to him be glory forever and ever. Amen. Why? I tell you why. Because he sees the glory of God in the cross. He sees the glory of God in the cross. He sees the glory of the Father in the cross. You see, the only way to get to heaven is not by your own deeds. It's not by religion. It's not by politics. It's not by philosophy. It's not by your own intellect. It is by the cross of Christ. You see, he came down and he took a human flesh and he died on your behalf and shed his blood on your behalf. And Paul says, to whom be glory, honor, and praise. He says, this Savior deserves praise. He deserves to be glorified. He deserves to be worshipped because he came and died in your place. He died in your place. He gave his life as a sacrifice for you. We are having Harvest Day today. We are remembering those who died for us today. We're remembering those who died for us yesterday. And we for our country. But someone did a greater sacrifice. Savior, the perfect Messiah, he who done no lies, nothing wrong, himself for you and me. He gave himself for you and me. He shed his blood for you and me to save us from this evil world. Now, if you doubt me with an evil world, just think of the presidential election in America. Both candidates are not up to the job. You know it and I know it. We live in a present evil world, and Christ came and died on that cross for you. To rescue you from this present evil age. As we said before, so say now I again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than you have received, let him be accursed. For do I not persuade men of God, or do I seek to please men? For if yet if I please men, I should not be the servant of Christ. We are not in here for a popularity contest. You said, Jay, you're not popular. Paul was not popular. Jesus was not popular. The prophets were not popular. Those who are men and women of God are never ever popular. We're not here for a popularity contest. We're here to proclaim the truth that can set you free. I seek to please men, but if I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Christ. I'm here to please Christ. I'm here to bring glory to him. I'm here to lift him up and to tell you that the Son of God came and died on that cross to set you free. To set you free. That's why he died on that cross, to set you free. And if you cling on to that which is wrong, if you hold on to that which is unrighteous, if you cling on to that which is not right and glory in it, if you glory in sex outside of marriage, if you glory in drugs, glory in getting drunk, glory in stealing, if you glory in it, then you'll choke on it in hell. If you glory in it, you'll choke on it in hell. If you glory in swearing, if you glory in sleeping around, if you glory in stealing, if you glory in it, then it will be there with you in hell. But Christ took your punishment for you. He took your punishment. He died in your place to rescue you and bring you home. That's why he died for you. It says, and profited in the Jews' religion above many of my equals in my own nation, being more exceedingly zealous for the traditions of my fathers. Paul was zealously religious, but he didn't know God. Paul was a very religious man, but he never knew God when he was so religious. And you can be so religious that you miss the main thing, which is knowing God. We're not preaching religion, we're preaching Jesus Christ. Religion cannot get you into heaven, but Jesus Christ can. And Paul was a very religious man. He was extremely religious. He was a very devout Pharisee, a devout Jew. But yet he did not know God. He did not know the ways of God. He was not saved until God met with him. In Acts chapter 9, Jesus came to him and said, persecute thou me. Why persecute thou me? And the Lord spoke to Paul and made him realize that his religion was nothing. He had to meet with Christ. And that is what you need today. You need an encounter with Christ. You need to have an encounter with Christ. You need to know Christ. He says, my sheep hear my voice. He says, I lay down my life for my sheep. And you've got to know him as your shepherd. You've got to know him as your Lord. You've got to know him as your Savior. And when you have an encounter with Christ, you'll change. When you have an encounter with Christ, all will change for you. When you have an encounter with Christ, you'll be made anew. When you have an encounter with Christ, not religion, you become a living child of God, saved and born again. It's an encounter with Christ, not religion. You can be religious but miss the God. You can be religious but miss Jesus. You can be religious and go to church or go to mosque or go to any place of worship and yet still miss the living God when you're there because you're so religious, you're so full of rules and regulations, you miss what it's all about, which is to love God and your neighbor as yourself. And so we lift Christ up and we trust in him and we have an encounter with him. And it's a living relationship of life and power and joy. It's not something of rules and regulations, but it is to know Christ and to be full of him and to be full of the Holy Ghost and to be living in the Holy Spirit and to be living in the kingdom of God. And it begins by faith in Christ. And Paul is teaching this here. He's saying, faith in Christ. Do you have faith in Christ? Do you have faith in the Messiah, faith in the Lord, faith in Jesus Christ? Do you have faith in him? That is where it's at, my friend. Do you have faith in him? We've looked at, we've seen President Trump, we've seen Hillary Clinton, and they have big, massive failings in their life. But Jesus never had those failings. Jesus was perfect, he was holy and pure, he never lied, he never did anything wrong. He is the Messiah, he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He is the Messiah, he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He never did anything wrong, he was perfect, he was holy, he was pure, he was the Savior, he never did anything wrong. And John the Baptist said this, he said this, he said, Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Behold him who knew no wrong. Behold him who was perfect. Behold him who was pure. Behold the Lamb of God who loved and died on that cross for you. Behold him. God bless you. Behold him. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Christ. Behold him. The politicians will let you down. Trump will let you down. Hitler will let you down. But behold him, the Lamb of God. They won't put Brexit in. They're dragging their feet, these elites in Parliament. They don't want to bring Brexit in. They don't want to listen to the ordinary people. But Christ is for the ordinary person. He is the Lamb of God who came to take away your sin. He is the Lamb of God that shed his blood on your behalf. He's the one that came to save you. He's the one that came to give his life for you. And I don't care for all of the men. On which the Prince of Glory died. When I survey the Prince of Peace, what a him. What about this? And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's love? And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's love? Oh, and can it be that I'd be into pawn? That I'd be into stealing? That I'd be into sleeping around? That I'd be into spies? I'll be taking drugs. No! And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's blood? And can it be that I should gain an interest in the Savior's blood? Oh, that you would have that interest in him. Oh, that you would taste and see that the Lord is good. That to know Christ is joy, to smoke spice is death. To take crack cocaine is death. To steal from the tax man is death. But to know Christ is life. It's joy and peace in the Holy Spirit. It's joy in the Lord. Jesus said, he came to give us joy. There's real joy in Jesus. There's real satisfaction in him to know the Lamb of God. To know that your sins are forgiven. He says, come to me. All you who are heavy laden and I will give you rest. He says, come to me. Come to him. Leave the spice. Leave the crack cocaine. Leave the stealing. Leave the sleeping around. He says, come to me. Come. I love you. I want you. Come to me. He says, come to me. All you who are weak and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Christ can give you rest. Drugs cannot give you rest. Spice cannot give you rest. Crack cocaine cannot give you rest. But he says, come to me. He can give you rest. You're worried about your mortgage. You're worried about your career. You're worried and worried and worried when you get up in the morning about the world. He says, come to me. put it upon him. Lean upon him. Lean upon the Lord that owned him. Rock of ages, cleft for me. Let me hide myself in thee. Come to Christ and rest in him. And trust him when the world is falling apart. When your life is falling apart. There is a rock that you can stand on. And that rock is Christ. That rock is him. He'll not fail you. He'll not let you down. When the chips are down, he'll be there for you. When the chips are down, he'll stand. When the chips are down, he'll stand. Not to live for fame, not to live for power, not to live for sex, not to live for money. For me to live is Christ, to die is gain. To live for Christ, to lift him up and to worship him and adore him. The angels right now are worshipping him, saying, behold the Lamb of God. They are worshipping him right now, and you can worship him right now. Is it not time not to be worshipping yourself? Taking selfies of yourself. Always taking selfies of yourself. Why not take a selfie of Jesus? And believe in Jesus and worship Jesus. And trust in Jesus. And have him as your Lord and Savior. Let him take over your life. Give your life to him and say, Lord, I'm here. And let him take over. Let him guide you. Let him lead you in your life. Let him show you the way. Let him guide you in your life. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, my friends, there is a hell and a heaven. We did not come from Hades. We did not come from trilobites. We was not evolved. That is a myth, and it is a bare-faced lie. You did not come from evolution. You did not come from evolution. Well, your great-grandma is not a chimpanzee. Your great-granddad is not a koala bear. Well, have a debate with him, sir. He says, I don't understand. Debate with him. You've got no intellectual foundation then, sir. I can give you some evidence that we've got the wrong right by us. One jumps in the most thing right in by London. In your DNA, you have to be the information more complex than that sensor by London. That was created by chance. It doesn't make sense. Where there is information, there is a mind. In DNA, there is information. Therefore, the mind must have put it in there. There, you have God. Jesus Christ came to die on that cross for you. He gave his life for you. And he offers you salvation today. You trust him as your Lord and Savior. God bless you. Thank you.